right, so no bad words.
Buddy of mine delivered drywall.
All right. There you go. All right, yeah. Hey, give me a high five for good luck. All right, see ya.
Not at all. But you don't ever call unless you absolutely need one. So. It'll get moved up to the third story. We'll be able to slide it off on the carton and roll it down. It must be an apartment building or something. He didn't tell me what it is yet. He just looked at me. The sidewalk is bright. I got enough of that. I don't need no more now.
You know, the my service shit on
that.
That ain't happening anytime soon.
Okay. I'm like, I heard that and my heart just sank.
Make it up, please.
I don't know. I got it. Nope, just go.
Catch you later, guys.
Thank you. where a jazz band will perform, and Alex has a solo.
Oh, sweet.
I don't want double. I just bring it.
Right, so it's pretty simple. Yeah.
I'll do it.
Yeah.
just
oh yeah. Yeah.
So they said
just like flip the camera so it faces the band. Awesome. Thank you.
Way to be a team.
Yeah. How did I help?
Okay, so there's an outlet right there, so I'm going to plug that in right behind you.
Sure.
Thanks, guys.
Check 1, 2. All right. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our concert. Tonight is our send-off concert because we are heading out on tour tomorrow. So this show is going on the road tomorrow morning, and all these songs that we're sharing with you will be shared there as well. We'll be performing at St. Croix Falls High School first, and then we'll go to the Concordia University in St. Paul, Minnesota, where the band will be clinics by the band director there, and the choir will be clinics by the choir director there. So it's an exciting time. The choir today, they chose the theme of silence for this concert. And when they said that first, I was like, well, that's interesting, because we sing, we can't be silent, but that's what they chose. So all our pieces tonight relate to silence in one way or another. So our first piece tonight is titled Silence, which a lot of them have silence in the title, so it was a little bit confusing in rehearsals, but this first song is called Silence, and it's simply about being out in nature and enjoying the silence and thinking about how that's a good thing for us and how it also opens our minds to ask questions too. So I hope you enjoy our first piece titled Silence.
Thank you.
Our second piece is titled, Can You Hear Me? This is a piece that incorporates ASL, or American Sign Language, and it's a fun piece that during the song, they'll actually be signing sign language to match it. So, Can You Hear Me? The composer wrote, always try to be open and aware of other people. Thank you. Test. Okay, there we go. All right, so our next song is actually a set of two songs, and they kind of just morph right into each other. It's called Songs from Silence, and this was a piece that was written by a composer named Elaine Hagenberg, and she wrote this piece in reaction to the COVID pandemic when singing wasn't really allowed, it wasn't safe, we didn't know what was going on. And so she wrote this piece, and in the notes it said, in hope of healing during times of silence and distance. So this was her gift to the choral community, Songs from Silence.
Somebody's calling my name. Oh.
recognize this next one. This is a choral twist on the song made famous by Simon and Garfunkel, The Sound of Silence. voice. And I want to read the performance notes from the score that the composer wrote. If you could hear my voice, explore the idea of listening to our inner voice and how it can help lead us to living a much fuller and more engaged life. It is that voice that is so often not heard by today's youth. Confidence and being heard can be a large part of growing up today. And this song celebrates that inner voice, which can take young people to that place of self-discovery. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. good evening and welcome to the band's portion of tonight's concert. We are going to begin our performance tonight with one of John Williams' most famous marches. This is called Midway March. When people think of John Williams, they think of E.T. and Indiana Jones, Star Wars, Jaws, and Harry Potter. In 1976, John Williams scored the music for a lesser-known movie called Midway. This movie was about the Battle of Midway, and some say that this battle was the turning point of the U.S. war against Japan in World War II. John Williams is 91 years old, and he is still conducting today. I think Ethan always flew out to Los Angeles and saw him conduct earlier this year, so that's a really kind of cool thing. So, but this is Midway March by the great John Williams.
Thank you.
Testing. All right, I would like to welcome a new face to the podium for our next piece. Mr. Max Ellison is my student teacher from UW-Eau Claire this semester. He comes to us from Rosemont, Minnesota. I truly hope that he has learned as much from me as I've learned from him so far. He is just an awesome guy. He's doing a fantastic job here in Alpine Mountains, going to make the school very happy in the very near future. So please give a warm welcome to Mr. Max Ellison.
I'm Max Ellison, and I've been working with Mr. Murphy as a student teacher since about January. It's been such a pleasure working with these kids, so thank you for being willing to let me work with them, and thank you for bearing with me as I try to formulate like simple sentences sometimes. So this piece, oh Lord, that's the encouragement. Cool, we're gonna win this. So Erica Savano is a composer and conductor at Whitewater, Wisconsin. She's also a fellow UWBC alum, like Ian Sorfi. She has a very interesting sense of humor, and that shows in a lot of her composing. I've had the pleasure of playing a few of her pieces thus far, and all of them have like just a little element that's just a teensy bit unhinged about it. In Steampunk Suite, it's just the entire piece falling apart on purpose. In this one, it's featuring our percussionist Carissa on the iPad theremin, and it's sort of going for like a 1950s low-budget sci-fi horror movie vibe, so if you could demonstrate a little bit of that quick. Very cool. Hopefully I've stalled long enough for the percussion to be ready and good to go, get some brass chops back, and we're good to go. So keep your hands and feet inside the ride, stay seated the entire time, and enjoy your ride on the haunted carousel.
Thank you.
All right, thank you for that awkward scene change. Oh, you did a very good job. We're going to transition here. This is our jazz band. They come in twice a week. Well, sometimes it's Tuesdays and Thursdays, sometimes it's Mondays and Wednesdays, and sometimes it's whenever I decide to tell them to come on in. So they're troopers. They pretty much do whatever I ask them to do, which is really, really awesome. So we're going to perform one song for you tonight. We actually have two songs that we're working on right now, with the third one about this is going to get started here pretty soon, getting ready for the Eau Claire Jazz Festival, which is happening next month. But this is the very famous Chameleon, and we're going to famous Alex Woodford on the alto saxophone. This is Chameleon.
St. Croix Falls in times for our first performance. So that's all I want to say. And now the band will do their last piece of the night.
All right, so as I selected music for tonight's performance, I intentionally selected music written in uncomfortable time signatures for these students. So much of our literature that we play in middle school and high school band is in 4-4 time, 2-4, 3-4. Midway March was written in 12-8 time. Our Jet 7 is written in 7/8 time and 3 transitions into 6/8 and 4/4. So that was one reason I chose this piece. The second reason I picked it is because it's just a really cool piece. So it's a fun song and it's a great piece to close off the concert with. So but before we close off the concert, if your child is going on the Twin Cities portion of the trip this weekend, I passed out a blue medical form that we need every student to fill out and turn back into us. And I've gotten probably a handful of them, but not nearly all of them yet. So if your child has not turned one in, or you brought it home to you, which I don't know how that would happen, but if they've not turned it in to you, I've got them all here in my stand. Just feel free to come up here and after the concert and get a medical form in case something happens, we can react accordingly. And then the last thing, before we close this wonderful concert, every student, please take, when we're done, please take your chair and your stand and percussion equipment, and we need to clear this all out before we leave. So this should go, and don't say no to me, don't say no, no. So, and you're gonna take two chairs for that. Do you have anything else you wanna say? Okay, good, that's what I thought. So, but please take everything. We should be able to get this whole thing cleared out in about 3 minutes. And if Ann Byer leaves early, please stop her. So, we hope you enjoy our Jetsam by Randall Standridge. Thanks for being an awesome audience, folks.
Thank you.
Let's give an extra round of applause to Ann Meyer for entertainment purposes. Nice job, Ann. Woo! Then everybody have a great night. Students, please take a chair and stand. And a couple chairs. Kelsey Mavis, Carly Gerken, and Ethan Owers were all featured in that last song. Let's give them a round of applause. And now, thank you. Have a wonderful night, everybody. Thanks so much.
Yeah. Tom's not, but I'm ready.
Somebody
Adrian.
Not talking to me.
Change every What's that?
I met my student teacher. He came to the concert.
Oh, nice.